Well, thank you for joining us, Betty. You've been at the helm of the Kenya Association of Manufacturers since 2004. How has been your journey so far?
I joined the association in 2004 and replaced Mr. Ngugi, who was a former CEO then. So it's actually a bit more than just a little bit, around 8 years since I came. KAM is a business organization, it's a business lobby group. So obviously one of the things that you look at is how many members it has, how influential it is with government and getting results in terms of its own advocacy, and basically how it grows. And I think one of the things that people who are in Kenya will be aware of is that it's an old organization, so it's been influential for most of its life. It's got a long history of great influence with government and partnership with government. So what we've done in the last 8 years is to build on that tradition of access and influence and trusted partnership with government, and I think we're all quite excited by the results.
Now, currently manufacturing sector accounts for about 15% of the country's GDP. What plans has KAM put in place to grow these numbers?
I think growing the manufacturing sector is going to be both a responsibility of entrepreneurs and the government, government of the day. It is true that the manufacturing sector has been around 10-15% of the economy for the longest time since independence, actually. And a sign of a real transforming economy is growth in the service sector and in the manufacturing sector. And I think one of the challenges that we've all faced is that we haven't seen the results and the increase in the portion of manufacturing sector in Kenya, partly because of the costs of doing business in Kenya and the cost of running a manufacturing concern. When we look at the cost of doing business in Kenya, the first thing that people will point out to is obviously the cost of energy and the cost of production itself. We think this is a sector that can grow and can be, can represent a much greater share of the economy, and that is actually what the country requires. But you're not going to do that without access to affordable or reasonably priced energy in significant quantities where industries can locate, without looking at the policies that would spur industrial development. We talk a lot about the fact that we're an agricultural country, but we need to also look at how much we're doing in terms of value addition. We didn't always have minerals. Now we're discovering minerals. We've seen not just looking at oil, but now looking at the other minerals that are possible within Kenya.
Now, manufacturers have in recent months complained about the inefficiencies at the Port of Mombasa and are saying it is resulting in the country having a high cost of doing business. How much of a risk does this pose for the country's competitiveness?
No, if the port of Mombasa doesn't become competitive, I think we can pretty much shut down Kenya and say it's not competitive, because Kenya is a small, outward-oriented economy. It cannot rely on its 40 million people for a market. So any growth in Kenya has to be export-led. Therefore, the port plays a critical role. We cannot fly everything out. We have to use the port. So I think it's critical that the port works. And it's not just for Kenya's sake, it also has potential for spurring more business, because it serves the hinterland, serves Uganda, serves Rwanda, serves Congo, serves Burundi. And if it doesn't get more efficient, we're going to lose business to other ports.